No, come on. What?
Pardon?
That was the worst day of my fucking life.
So far, so far.
Fucking fly.
Ed Gamble.
I'll be honest, you should never have to remove your own cloche. That's bad restaurant etiquette. Feed yourself a grape.
It's a classic case of murder. What have you found? Ned!
Your dog seems quite athletic.
He's been in the force for about 25 years. It's his final case, and someone's unfortunately been murdered by a grape. Mm. But the only thing from the weapon that Officer Dickhead could find was the stalk of the grape, but they knew it was done by an actual grape, so they call on, finally, Ned, the old rickety police dog, the only dog on the force who could sniff out grapes.
Yeah.
And he comes, final job, but he's been treated badly in the force, so he takes his opportunity to enjoy a lovely grape on his last day, thus destroying the case.
Yeah, and his kidney, they are toxic for dogs.
That's why it's his last case.
There isn't a backstory like what you've got with the dog.
I made mine up.
OK, yes.
You what?
Yeah.
Right, man!
You look ready for action?
Yeah, big help, big hole. It's only when you stand back and look at it you realise quite how bad it is.
Wonderful's the word we're looking for,
we're
right?
We're looking for wonderful.
Ed Gamble.
Oh,
wonderful scene. Here it is.
Jesus Christ.
He ran out of room, but it says evil butcher. He slightly misjudged the space there. But...
it's pretty graphic.
I'm a big fan of heavy metal and horror films.
Yeah.
And if I see a good horror film, I see a good heavy metal album cover, I go, whoa, that is wonderful, actually.
Do you?
If I go and see a heavy metal band, they'll come out and they'll play a song and I'll go, that was a wonderful song.
I mean, what I will say is, it makes sense.
What? Alex's leg, cos it's gorgeous.
Yeah, gorgeous. Gorgeous. I know who I'm taking to Pompeii.
Do you think I can build a river? Think I can sail the duck all the way down? Some other people might do something similar, so I... speed is the...
Yes, you're running very fast.
Sorry! Right, I'm gonna send the duck down just to see what happens, OK?
He's coming.
Is he moving? He stopped. We're gonna do this. Ah! Ah! Oh shit! Is he still moving forward, Alex?
Backwards now.
Oh man!
Chill out, Ed.
I can't chill out. I want this to work.
Approaching the half-hour mark.
You understand, I can't give up now.
Careful!
I mean, I don't know how I'm going to get the water up there now. Oh!
Good luck, Ed.
I mean, technically, I guess I've moved the rope there. What I'm going to do to make sure that I don't get penalised for it is I'm going to move it even further back! We go again! Ow! Come on!
And that's going to be an issue as well, isn't it?
It just is the worst day of my life now. Started off quite promising, I thought.
That was a long time ago.
The only way I get out of this with any dignity is if I die right now. Is he there, Alex?
He's in the tunnel.
Where is he? Get this duck into that pond. What duck? Stop the clock.
Oh, clock stopped. Thanks, Ed.
claiming to have destroyed any evidence
the duck,
of the duck.
Buried it in two separate locations so it can't haunt me. And
the first couple of minutes, I thought, this is just an engineer at his prime.
Oh, we all did.
It really did start to unravel after that initial feeling of hope.
Yeah.
All fun went out after the first hour. It was...
What? How long was he there?
97 minutes and 9 seconds, and he still didn't do it.
It was 97 minutes of utterly wasted time.
And 9 seconds.
I've never seen such a well-dressed loser, though.
And afterwards, were you genuinely angry?
I believe that was quite early on. That was quite early on in the day. That was before lunch. So if you needed the dog thing explaining, that's why I did.
Place your bag on the circle near the taskmaster, who will guess whether you were packing bricks or balloons. In the 100 seconds.
Balloon.
He's singing balloon, I think.
Brick. Balloon or brick.
Oh, that's a clever man.
I'm all packed for Pompeii, baby.
I think that Ed Gamble is packing balloons.
So when I say I'm packed for Pompeii, just want to let you know that I'll be paying for my own ticket.
Tell us the final scores.
Well, Ed came last.
Yay! I'm guesting at one of the Edinburgh Fringe shows, and he'll say something about having a load of great guests and also me. And I guarantee that that's what he'll do.
If we're playing Richard Herring bingo,
yeah,
that's popping up on the cards.
It is, funny.
It is funny. It makes me laugh every time.
He's very funny. He's a very funny guy.
He is very funny.
And you can be funny by being mean to Ed. We just choose not to be. We just choose to treat him with the deference he deserves.
And also he'll bring up winning Taskmaster Champion of Champions.
Yeah, it's a shame, isn't it?
Nah. I love it. I like to have a bit of a, you know, I meant to lose.
You maintain your underdog status.
Well, no, because, you know, I won a series, but then, you know, who wants that guy again to win, right?
It's no, just exactly.
Arrogant, isn't it?
I mean, didn't everyone who got on the Champion of Champions win a series?
Yeah, but...
They didn't all come last, though, did they? Did you come... You last on that?
Yeah, I came last, yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know what?
We all do that.
It's a bit like in Edinburgh when they say if you can get the rainbow... You know, you get 5 stars, 2 stars, 3 stars, 1 star.
Didn't come fourth, third, or second, though.
No, but
only first and last.
No, but I did the best one.
What do you mean the best one?
5 and 1, the best ones.
5 and 1,
but the worst one as well.
No,
the best.
Richard won his series and then won the Champions.
Yeah, boring.
One.
Yeah.
So boring.
It was best and best.
Okay, look at the last time it happened, right? Champion of Champions. The person who came bottom, Bob Mortimer, National Treasure. Ed Gamble, Bob Mortimer, National Treasures.
Yes.
Top, Richard Herring, Josh Widdicombe. Boring. Both boring.
Absolute, you know, just like buttered bread, isn't it? Like, kind of everyone kind of likes it, but it's
I
no
love
one's...
buttered bread.
I love buttered bread.
I want to be buttered bread.
Have some buttered... We're going to have some buttered bread. You listen to the news. We're delighted to be joined by one of my favourite comedians.
Well, and what? Let's not forget about our guest.
Oh, yes. One of my favourite comedians, Richard Herring, is here. Hello, Richard. How are you doing?
Hello. I'm very good. How are you, boys?
Very,
very
good.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much for coming on the show, Richard.
Nah, thank you for having me. It's very exciting.
Richard, you are off to Edinburgh.
Yes.
Have you booked all of your guests? Do you know who's going to be there on which day? Are there a few?
I've got nearly all of them. I haven't done anyone for the last one yet, and I might leave it just in case I bump into Sir Ian McKellen in the street, persuade him to come for the last one.
That's the magic of the Fringe.
I've had to take a chance. I'm taking a chance on someone called Ed Gamble. doing one of them.
Yes. That's on the 11th of August.
Okay, so yes, so I don't know what he'll be like.
I've heard he's pretty hot rather than not.
Okay. Well, that will be for the public to decide.
I mean, I would recommend people come and watch that one in particular because it is always fun to watch me and Richard just snipe at each other for a full hour.
What's your problem with Ed? He's a nice lad.
He seems to have a problem with me. I think it's because I'm better at time.
Yeah, we knew that was going to come up.
That's what it is.